Hey everybody, Ann here. It is Thanksgiving. Happy Thanksgiving to all of you. I'm in my kitchen and I gotta start cooking. Yep, I'm cooking Thanksgiving dinner, but it's not gonna be the same kind of Thanksgiving dinner as I usually do. It's gonna be a little bit different. So the first thing I gotta do is get together the chutney. First, the ingredients. I'm using sliced almonds, and I couldn't find fresh cranberries, so those are dried cranberries, some rehydrated celery, cowboy candy chutney that I had made previously, and some pineapple juice and pineapple chunks. Instead of orange juice this year, I'm using the whole can of pineapple juice, just getting it all in there. And I didn't use the whole can of pineapples. I'm going to use some of it for later, but I didn't like it all chunked up like that, so I kind of mashed it. Crushed pineapple would have been better, but I didn't have it, so mashed it all up. And next, I'm putting the whole jar of cowboy candy chutney in there and just going to give it a little stir, get it all mixed up. Next, I'm adding the cranberries that have been partially rehydrated and some rehydrated celery for my survival food and some sliced almonds. I don't think that's enough yet. I got to add some more almonds. And then some cinnamon and some ginger. And then next, 3 tablespoons of brown sugar. There's already sugar in the cowboy candy chutney, but I wanted to add some more because it's pretty spicy. And then I added another cup of water just because I'm rehydrating the cranberries, and I did end up adding more cranberries because I didn't think I had enough. I'm starting this out on the propane cooktop, so I'm putting a cover on it and just gonna let it cook. Cranberry chutney is cooking and it is smelling absolutely wonderful. It's raining. It's gonna rain all day long. What? That's Sunny. He wants to be my lap so bad. Stop it. So I have to let the chutney cook until it's done. And it's pretty early. It's only like 7:30, 8 a.m. I've already let the chickens out and everything. Because I've only got one pot that size that I need to cook the stuffing in. I just cook things in succession. So when that cranberry chutney is done, I will start cooking the stuffing. And then I get to start layering the... You know what? The cranberry chutney is done. The cranberries have plumped up quite a bit, and the ones that haven't are really still very soft. Let me take a little taste. Get a little bit of everything in it. It's gonna be good. Yep. So I need to let this cool off a little bit before I put it in the plastic bowl. That is so good. It has, like I said, the cowboy candy chutney that I made from before. And it's sweet and it is spicy. Oh my goodness. Next, we're going to make the kind of candy yams. I just got a can of yams down there. I dumped out half the fluid. Going to add some pumpkin pie spice. I like it pretty spicy. And then 3 tablespoons... of delicious brown sugar. Oh yeah, that's gonna be good. I just kind of stirred this up a little bit. Oh, and I didn't tell you, I put some ghee in there too, some butter, so that's gonna be, make it really rich. I usually put pecans in it too, but I'm not gonna do that this year. There's plenty of almonds in the chutney, so I'm just gonna let this cook for a little bit and reduce down just a teeny bit and then get started on the rest. So what do we got so far? We've got some cranberry chutney. I just went ahead and made the stuffing. I just made it out of a box. No big deal. I didn't add all the stuff that I usually add to my stuffing. But and some very stiff mashed potatoes. And I'm going to show you why I made them so stiff in a little bit. I've also rehydrated the corn and green beans and mushrooms as well. Now, I'm going to leave that fluid in there because I'm going to use it to cook with. And, well, we'll just show you that in a bit. Now we're going to get it started on the green bean casserole. I'm not going to use the whole can of cream of mushroom soup. Just probably about half of it. Yep, about half is going to be good enough. Okay, where did I put those onions? I love these onions so much. Oh yes. I wish I had got another pack. I saved a little tiny bit for the top of my creation. Alrighty. Where's the Worcestershire? Oh, I've got the Worcestershire. Oh, yeah. This stuff is delicious. Somebody sent me some Liam Perrin's, however you say it, barbecue sauce, and I'm so hooked on this brand now. A little bit more. I almost forgot sour cream, and I've got it. Sour cream powder. You usually reconstitute it first and then throw it in whatever dish you're going to use, but I'm just going to put some down in there and stir it up real good, and hopefully it works. Oh, yeah. I think that's going to work just fine. I'm going to stir that up really, really well, and then I'm going to let it cook for a little bit. Just because these still need to get rehydrated just a little bit more. And then the final step of my luscious creation is going to take place. I got my fire started so I can get the Coleman Camp oven heated up to about 350 or so. Yeah, this is the first time I've lit a fire all day because it's been relatively, well, I call it warm. It's been above 50 degrees outside. Almost 6 degrees inside, so let's get this fire going. All right, it is time to put this thing together. First layer is mashed potatoes, and I wanted them kind of firm because I didn't want them to turn to mush at the bottom because there's going to be lots of sauces and whatnot going over the top of it. The next layer is the green bean casserole. I know it looks gross, but it isn't. It is actually quite delicious. I put a few more mushrooms in it than you would normally expect in a green bean casserole, but that's just me. I love mushrooms. Next are the yams. And I just took a taste of them. They're delicious. They're more like a, I don't know, a casserole. I usually make them so that you can tell that there's yams in it, but it didn't turn out that way this year. It doesn't matter. I just wanted another flavor layer. So we got yams. Next, we got a layer of stuffing. And you know what? This box stuffing is surprisingly tasty. So let's see if I can fit the rest of it in there. I got some corn. Next is a cranberry chutney. I love this stuff. I've never tasted anything like it. It's different than the chutney that I usually make. It is absolutely delicious. I've been snacking on it all day long. Whew, this is getting full. We got one more layer to go. I didn't want to buy a whole turkey or even a turkey breast, so I just went to the deli and I said, cut me up some thick steaks, and she did. I've already been eating off of it, and I gave some to the puppies and Papa. So I need to put this on the top of the casserole. I can only fit 1.5 slices on. That's okay. I can eat the rest here and there. All right, so now I need to see if I can get the gravy on it. Oh my gosh. Okay, that looks gross because it's gravy out of a can, but I think it'll be okay. I've just kind of put it on the top because we all know it's going to go down the sides and whatnot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to wrap this whole thing in foil. So hopefully it won't make a mess of my oven. Oh, there's one more thing. Ta-da! Now I just got to wrap it in foil and shove it in the oven. Look at it. It's like a Hershey's Kiss. Yeah, it's several layers too because it's kind of thin foil, but I know that this is going to bubble over and spill and everything, so hopefully this will contain it. We will see. It's in the oven for you, Mr. Casserole. Wow, that oven heated up quickly. It's in. I have no idea how long it's going to take to cook, but I'm going to give it at least 30 minutes because basically all it needs to be is heated through. So all this is going to be delicious. I just hope it's going to be delicious. It's been cooking for about 35 minutes, and it is steamy hot. I stuck my finger down in there and practically burned myself, so I'm going to open this up and put it back in the oven and let it brown up a little bit. Ooh, it is steamy hot. I think it's sufficiently browned, so I don't know. Should I let it sit for a little bit? Oh, gosh, I'm starving. You know what? I'm going to go ahead and plate this up. And there it is. It's ready to taste. I can't wait. Yep, I'm being a glutton. I'm having 2 slices of bread. Oh, I just know this is going to be delicious. Time for a taste test. Look at my face. Oh, my cheeks are like totally red because it is hot in here. I'm going to have to open up a window, but not before I get a taste of this. Oh, I can't wait. Oh, big piece of turkey. Incoming. You knew I was going to say it was delicious, right? That turkey's really good. Oh my gosh. And the flavors, all the flavors together. Now, hold on. Hold on. Chutney. Oh my gosh. It is so good. Now, there we go. I usually make the casserole with leftovers. And everybody takes, you know, takes a casserole home if that's what they want to do. You can layer it any way you want. But if you're looking for an idea of what to do with leftovers and you don't want to store a bunch of different things or whatever, just make a casserole. Just put your layers in it. Put whatever you want in it. But this is so good. And I'm really glad that I made those potatoes firm on the bottom, because I can still tell there's mashed potatoes down in there. And that, the kind of like spiciness from the cowboy candy chutney that I had made, and then augmented with the cranberries. Oh, it just pulls it all together. All right, let me finish eating. I am done eating, and that was really, really delicious. I've still got 3/4 of the casserole left, but it's going to get eaten, that's for sure. I've had to open up a window, like, all the way, because it's pretty hot in here with that wood burner going, because it's been, like, 50 degrees outside anyhow. I hope you all are having a good Thanksgiving, and let me know what you did down in the comments section, whether you spent it with family or whether you spent it by yourself with your animals like I did. Let me know if you ate anything unusual or something usual. Well, I think that's really all I've got for you. Just happy Thanksgiving. And I have a feeling this coming year is going to be much, much better. It has to be, right? Anyways, that's all I got for you guys today. See you in the next video. Thanks for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure you like, subscribe, hit the bell, and y'all have a good one.